Alright, so we're currently working on a setup here where we can have all of our gear for recording and maybe streaming or whatever in basically one little cart. We've got all of the hardware set up pretty much how I want it. I've got a monitor here, I've got an arm for my microphone, got an arm for my camera, it's on the rolly cart. I guess the only thing I really haven't done is figure out a way to attach that light to this pole, but that may even be possible by adding another arm in here or something. I'm not sure. Something to look into. Although, I might not even stick with this cart because it looks to me like it's kind of not the most sturdy of things, but it's definitely taking care of what I needed to take care of right now. The only thing that's not working for me is the PC that I'm using doesn't fit onto the cart. So I was hoping I just had one laying around that I could just throw on here and call it a day. But instead, I don't. The PC that I am using is my old PC, which is too tall to fit there. I have another PC that I was working on here, which is a decent enough one, but is definitely far too large to fit down there. So what I've gone on to now is I've pulled this out, and this is what we were using for a Plex server before I upgraded to the one we're using now. The problem with this one is that this one is definitely not going to perform as I would hope it would. So what I'm hoping to do is just take the motherboard and processor and stuff out of here, put into this one, because that will definitely give me the performance that I'm looking for. Overall goals will just be to be able to fit it on that bottom shelf there, which I think this will accomplish fairly nicely. I'll need to be able to hook up the camera to it, the soundboard to it, and be able to connect to the internet. And I think that I have solutions for all of those things somewhere laying around here. So we're going to try to get that done and see if we can't put it on there and see if everything works out that way. So let's get started with that. First thing I want to do is open up this and see what we're going to have here. So, with this being on here, I should be able to pull this around fairly easily. What we've got here is this. Very nice, very large fan there. It's got the stock cooler on it, so this is an Intel, I don't remember which one it was, but I think it was one of the lower end Xeons. This particular graphics card here was a 480 or a 580. I think it was a 480, but it was a mining only card, so it only has DVI out, which is fine. Doesn't have to be fantastic for what I was going to use this system for anyways. So yeah, we've got, what are these? Are these 4 gig sticks? Or are these 2 gig sticks? I can't remember what these are either. It's been a long time. Let me pull one out real quick and we'll see. So we got here 2 gig sticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them. So that means this system's going to have 12 gigs of RAM. This is registered. 600R, so 910BO is the things. I might, these are registered, 2 gigs each. I might actually have some more laying around. And actually, these are 4 gig sticks over here. So if you can see this side, this system here, this was also something I was playing around with. This board came out of a Dell T7500 workstation, and this cooler right here was one that I ordered from AliExpress, or or maybe it was Wish, one of those. Works pretty good. It came with some fans, but it's actually so good on this particular chip that it doesn't even actually need the fans. But I'm going to steal the RAM out of that. So 4 gigs. We got 6 of them here. So that'll be 24 gigs of RAM. We're going to drop that into this system over here.
This should be... This is also 10600R910E1 is this.
Numbers on those. Alright, so... We can go ahead and do that now while it's standing here. Now, that system that's behind me, that particular board will not fit into either of these two systems. That's why it's on that makeshift little stand that I made for it there.
Because I don't remember which Xeon that one has in it either. I think that one is the 5660, maybe?
Can't remember. So if that be the case,
and I'll have to check again and make sure what this one is. But if it's one that's compatible, I may just swap those two CPUs out there and see. So yeah, I don't want to have to worry about keeping up with those. I don't remember what this one is. I guess it will help me to check that out later once I get this thing out of here and moved over.
Since I will be populating every single slot in this system, it doesn't matter if I get them into specific slots, because since it will fill all of the slots, I will automatically be in all of the available channels. Yeah, actually I already have an SSD in here too, so I'll move that over because I didn't already have one for that. So that'll be good. Yeah. Looks like everything's going to work out good. I'll just take basically everything from here and go straight over with it. This is a different CPU. Oh, I already robbed this CPU to make a system for my daughter to use. Okay, so depending on what's in here. See, I bought a T3500 system, and it had, this is the, what is this? The E 5504 on it. And so I took the 5660 or 57, whatever it was. I took that other system and put it on there.
Bunch of stuff has happened. It's now 2 days later, and this needs to be done 4 in the morning. It's not. So we got to get that done now. agree with something here. If we get as far as the screen giving us an error code, we don't even get that far. So, well, at the very least, we do have all the power in the reset switches plugged into the right spots. Alright, so let's move on to what I think is the problem. Plug this. Power out. So what may be going on here, that even though that RAM and this RAM are both registered RAM, registered ECC RAM, it still might not work with it. Replacing the original RAM, then we will try something else. We'll start with that for now. V600R. Basically the same stuff. Different size sticks is 2 gigs instead of 4 gigs. Perhaps this board just doesn't support that much no more. I know that memory was working on that other system. But we'll see. Let me turn it on. Okay. From the lack of the beep, that leads me to believe that at least something is different. It's doing something. Oh, it is defaulting to that. How about that? Alright, so I guess let's go out of this then. Try to get into the BIOS then and see if we can change that to, or it defaults to the card instead of on board. I kind of need all of that working. Thank you. some reason, 24 gigs of RAM was just not working in this system. Whether that be because this board didn't support it or whatever. I don't know. There shouldn't have been any real difference. It's the same latency, same type of same speed of RAM. The only difference is these are 4 gig sticks instead of 2 gig sticks. So either this board just doesn't support this much RAM, or it just doesn't support these big of a stick of RAM. I don't know. I'm not even really sure which board this is. It's been a very long time since I ordered this board. But for some reason, that doesn't work. But we did get it working, so instead of the 24 gigs, we have 12 gigs of RAM, which is still going to be enough for this. Alright, so coming back out here, thing is restarting. Says it's downloaded a couple of updates. It did not finish downloading the latest AMD drivers for this card, but that might not be super bad because one of the updates that was listed in Windows Update was an AMD graphics driver. So, great, I guess. Whatever. As long as it is able to make this be 1024, I mean not 1024, as long as it's able to make this a 1920 by 1080 display, whenever I put it onto the other system and try to capture some camera footage and stuff from it, then that's all that matters right now. as far as getting the absolute latest and most greatest drivers for everything, I can easily do that tomorrow whenever I'm at work waiting for waiting for it to be time to actually need this thing. Just about time to go. There we go. Alright. So, let's see. Display settings now. Like, feels a lot better. Yeah. There we go. Let's go ahead and install OBS Studio. Now, this thing looks like it's ready to go, so I'm going to have to shut this down for a minute and try to see if we can get it running over here. So give me just one moment. Yep, give me just one moment to get that done, and we'll check it out there. There was no audio over here whenever I did it that way. I did get a little bit of footage, and I tried talking. It looked fine over here. I'm probably going to have to do some things with maybe a USB hub or something to be able to have enough ports to plug everything into. Hopefully that all works out fine. We'll see. If not, my next option might be to take the board out of that computer, which is my old work computer, and put it into here. Problem with that is there's no room in this case to install all the water cooling that I have in that case. So what I might have to end up doing is going and putting all of the air cooler back onto that that board if I do drop it into here. So we'll see how that goes after I try it with this one. If everything works out great with this one, then great, we'll stick with it. If it doesn't work out super good with this or whatever, if we have any issues, then that'll be my next option. But for now, I think we're going to be okay with this. I will put all of this back together, haul this to work with me tomorrow, where I can do all the updates on it from there. and then after work, when we do our live stream, I'll get to test it out and see how it works. Hopefully all that works out good, but we will see when we get around to that. Thank you guys for watching this video, watching me put all this together. If you guys like what you see here, if you want to see more of this, give it the thumbs up, leave us a comment in the bottom down there, and let me know what you think about these things. If you don't like it, tell me about it, give me the thumbs down.
Yeah, just let me know what you think. Catch you later.